Students, when was an entire group project ruined because of one member? I used to have this classmate that only talked about partying. When our teacher put us together in the same group for a project, I knew that something will happen. I tried telling others that we should anticipate something from him, but I didn't want to impose this bad stigma about him. They all disagree with me, saying that he has good marks and that he will be an asset to this project. In total, there were 8 of us assigned to a project that was supposed to cover every aspect of human biology. All groups had to cover a certain relevant topic, and we had the DNA, probably the most difficult one compared to the other ones. On the day of presenting the project, he texted last minute saying he won't show up for school today because he got really drunk last night with his girlfriend and that he's feeling hungover, so he won't be able to present. He asked if somebody else can fill in for him. We didn't know his material and looked like fools in front of the teacher, so the whole thing felt unfinished. Surprisingly, we were given good marks, despite the fact that we missed an important section of the project. On the other hand, the teacher gave him an individual test for failing to present the project. All I can say is that in the end, his mark was not as good as ours. My school was really focused on arts, and as for a group project, we were given the task to build the model of a house using only recycling materials. The foundation of the model was of 20 inches, so we had the space to come up with something truly marvelous. We were divided into groups of 5, and we had a month to finalize the project. All of my classmates were dedicated students, and their work ethic was impeccable. No one missed a group meeting, and all of us seemed to share interesting idea and interest for the project. This is something that you don't usually find on group projects. We've decided that the best way to move forward is for each of us to do a part of the house and then glue everything together. We had the plans for it and everything. Everyone knew what they were doing. On the last week before the deadline, we got together at Phil's house to put everything together. We stayed up late, making sure that everything is perfectly fit and glued together. We have made the final adjustments, making sure the model looks proper, and then we left, deciding that the best way is to leave the model at Phil's and he would bring it on the next day as it was easier for him, given the fact that he was driving. We were all happy that we finished on time and rather tired after all that hard work. The following day, we were supposed to present our project. We have waited and waited for Phil to arrive. He was usually late for everything else, so we didn't expect him to be on time. However, when more than 15 minutes passed, we got angry and started to call him. He told us that he got into a car accident and that he is fine, but the car and the model, which was on the passenger seat, were destroyed in the crash. Apparently, he was late and in a hurry, so he ran a red light. Good thing that nothing serious happened to him, but I was still mad at him. Don't get me wrong, I was glad he was okay, but there is no need to go fast when you know that the model was fragile. He should have gotten out of bed early and avoid being late, then this whole mess wouldn't have happened. We showed the teacher pictures of the project that we took as we went along, so she won't think that we are lying. Phil also sent some pictures of his wrecked car. We begged to be given a second chance, and to our surprise, she agreed. She said that given the circumstances, we have 2 additional weeks to put everything back together. The final project after that felt really rushed, and it just wasn't the same. The team's vibe was also off, knowing that the hard work that we've put in was all gone now. We knew it was Phil's fault, but nobody said anything to him because he was feeling bad about the situation too. Better to be 2 hours early than 2 minutes late. For the final mark on that school year, we had to prepare a group project. Our teacher wanted us to do something more interactive, as she put it. We were to be divided into groups, and then we were given a topic at random. She told us that the project will consist of a PowerPoint presentation, which must include a video at the end. The video was the main element of the whole presentation, and doing this right will secure us a good mark that will help us to end the year with a bang. We were given some topic about politics, which seemed quite boring, but at least it was easy to talk about, so doing that would be a breeze, we thought. We got together in our group, and after a quick discussion, we managed to come up with a few interesting ideas. Someone will gather and summarize the content, and 2 people will be dealing with the video, one of which being myself. That left only one role to be filled, somebody to put together all the information and video onto PowerPoint slides and to tweak it a bit to make it more appealing. That was the simplest task, so we decided to give it to Joey. Joey was your usual classmate that didn't care much about school or his grades. We anticipated that he won't feel like working on the other tasks, and we didn't really take him for the serious type. but he should be able to manage this. So we've thought. We got together in the library on every Wednesday after school for the following 3 weeks to finish the project. Joey was never there. We expected this anyway, but it didn't bother us much because task was to focus on the final product after all. At the end of our sessions, we have put together all the material that should go onto the slides, and we have uploaded our video for the presentation on YouTube for ease of access. Joey offered to upload the video on YouTube as he has done it before with other videos, and he was familiar with the process. We gave clear instructions to Joey, and then he went on to do his magic. To our surprise, the next day he managed to finish everything. All in all, the PowerPoint actually looked good, so we were happy that Joey came through in the end. So far, so good. On the day of the presentation, we proceeded with confidence going over the content. We covered everything in a few minutes so that we would leave time for the video, which was a bit longer, and it was the main selling point of the presentation. And now I will present you the video that the team and I put together. I hope you will enjoy it, I said while clicking on the link, which I thought it would take me to the video. Next thing we know, a random video about video games comes up. It was about some guy doing streaming and he was swearing a lot and yelling. We stopped the video as soon as we could, but by then we were all embarrassed. We apologized, and then we've asked Joey to find the video or to log into his YouTube account since he was the one uploading it. He said that we won't be able to find it because he made the video private. Why on earth would you do that, Joey? I cracked. Not to worry, he replied. I will just access my account now. Turns out he didn't remember his darn password. I was slowly but surely making the transition from embarrassed to furious. He kept trying and trying, but he didn't manage to get in. By the time he got around that, our time was up. The teacher said that it wouldn't be fair to others to take more time than what was initially allocated because other groups won't get the chance to present their projects. I was extremely angry at Joey after that, and the whole group was as well. We haven't checked the link before because the slides were looking so good and we just assumed the link is fine. Didn't cross our minds one second. You had only one job. All of us failed, but our average mark was still decent considering the pass grades that we've gotten on our exams, with the exception of Joey. But no one cared about him at that point anyway. As much as I tried to avoid them, there was always some group project to encourage ourselves, the students, to develop our team working skill or whatnot. It wasn't that I didn't like people or that I was antisocial, but my teacher marked as a group rather than giving out individual marks on the way we each present. Her argument was that the project is the final product of the team, hence it reflects the work of everyone. What a bunch of gibberish. Anyway, she was the teacher and we were the students, so we complied. The topic was the First World War. I was quite passionate about history, so I wanted a really good mark. My classmates were clearly not interested about the project, so I tried to encourage them the best that I could to take this seriously. Naturally, I took the role of the leader and tried to inspire the initiative and vision for the project. My excitement was met with a lack of interest. In all honesty, I sort of expected that. Then I went to Plan B. When we were dividing the tasks among ourselves, I have offered to be in charge of all the content, as well as putting the project together. It was more work for me, but as long as I got my desired mark, it's all going to be worth it, I was telling myself. As said, I had managed to convince them that I can do the whole project by myself, which wasn't really difficult, figuring how lazy they were. After I made it really clear to whole group that I will do this and have the project ready a week before the deadline so that it gives everyone time to learn their part when we come to present. This was my only request, for them to learn the content and give out a decent speech. This implied the minimum amount of effort on their end, and I begged them to take this seriously and focus only on this because I will handle everything else. Their response was simply, "Do not worry, we can handle it. You do your part and we'll make sure to learn the content in time for the presentation." I didn't have much faith, but those words provided a bit of reassurance, so I went with it. There were a lot of sleepless nights, but I managed to finish everything in time, a week before the deadline, just as promised. The day of presenting the project finally arrived and I was excited. I began introducing the project and outlining the main points we were about to cover. Afterwards, as we discussed, it was their turn for each to present a certain section of the project. First off, finished my speech, and all went perfect, exactly as practiced. It was then my classmate's turn. Michael starts off. He wasn't fluent in the speech, but he was decent. He missed a few bits, though. I was thinking, relax, it could have been way worse. Lauren goes next. She was flawless. Good job, I was thinking. Douglas was the same. Things are really looking up now. Finally, there was Jessica. Ah, Jessica. She starts off confidently, then stutters. She then panics a bit and forgot her idea. I was thinking, please don't do this right now after everything went so perfectly. She then pulls out a tiny piece of paper from her pocket and starts reading it. But she was struggling to read her handwriting, which made everything worse. She clearly has no clue what's going on. She then gives up on the paper and turns her back at the screen, reading directly from the slides, word by word. The class started giggling and the whole thing became awkward. I was just sitting there with my eyes closed and my hand around the forehead like I wanted to hide and make this whole thing over quicker. I was embarrassed. At the end, the teacher made note of the fact that Jessica read from the slides, which was clearly stated before that we must not do because we will lose marks. The teacher then asked Jessica a few questions to test her knowledge regarding the project. You can probably guess that her answers were as silent as the night, because she didn't know anything. Finally, the teacher congratulated others and gave us a C. After all that hard work, I was marked as being average because somebody else was not able to put in the minimum amount of work.